If you're new to the channel, welcome. If you're not new, welcome back. Today we are going to be continuing on with our Laravel e-commerce series, and where we left off last time was to create orders for the authenticated users. If you'd like to follow along with the project, the link to the playlist is in the description down below. So to get this started, what I want to do is I want to head into the text editor, and I want to go ahead and head into the checkout index page. How I want to set this up is, instead of creating a whole new page for the confirmation, I just want to create a component that displays conditionally, so that this way we don't have to have an additional route, we don't have to inject any additional information into the confirmation page. Everything will be displayed right here, and again, it is for both authenticated and for non-authenticated users. All it is just a display. They can print the page, they can do whatever they want with the component itself. It will look just like the page, but it won't be its own route. So what we want to do is head up to, let's see, right up to the top here. And this is where the page is being displayed all together. This is the left side, this is the right side. So we're just going to display it on this page. It'll be in place of all of this information right here. So right up here, we can just go ahead. I'm going to paste all of this in so that you don't have to watch me do it. And then we'll go through what it is. So all it is a header that says, thanks for placing your order. It's got the confirmation number that we'll be passing in, the item, the quantity, the price. It'll be in this small little table type thing. We'll be looping over the order items that we're passing in. We are going to have a shop show page. So a link from this confirmation page, they'll be able to see the image item, and they'll also be able to link to that item if they want to go back and look at it again or whatever they want to do. We'll also have the item name. We'll show the quantity, price, the subtotal. We've already formatted the currency, so we'll have the billing subtotal. We'll have the billing discount, billing tax, and these are conditionally if there is a billing discount code in there. Okay, that's where the rest of this stuff will show. And that's pretty much it. So what I want to do now is I want to create a data property, and we'll call it isConfirmed. And we're going to set this to false initially. And before we get too deep, I want to shrink this down a little bit, and I want to have a template, well, two templates. The first will be for VIF is confirmed. And then we'll go ahead and put in that bit of code that I just pasted in here. And so it'll be able to display conditionally, and this one will put be else. So this will hold everything else in the page. So now, since we're getting the order from the Axios request that we're sending, that means that now, instead of console logging this data, we can set our order data property to this response data order. And after that's done, we can also do this is confirmed, we can set it to true. Let's give this a try and see what we have. And I need that user's email. Just pick this one. Put it in here. Let's open up our inspect in case we get an error, which it looks like we might have. Format currency is not a function. Oh, that's because that was the original way I had it. So let's go ahead and change this real quick. And do it like this. Filters, format currency. So hopefully that should work now. We'll go ahead and pay now. Do I have it somewhere else? Let's see. 2 of 5. Oh, one more. Okay, hopefully that should be good. Okay, so now you see we have, thanks for placing your order confirmation number is, blah, blah, blah. We have our item, it's clickable, and then we have the subtotal tax total. Fantastic. Two things that I want to show you. The first is I want to have a button so that we can print out this confirmation page. The other is if you go ahead and refresh this, you see that now we're just back at the checkout and that confirmation page is no longer available. So let's head into the text editor and start working on that button. So now before we get into the button, I want to take that confirmation component. I want to pull it out of this checkout page and I want to make it its own component. So to do that is very simple. We'll just go ahead and grab this. We're going to take this right out of here. We'll go over to the components folder in our JS folder and I just want to call it confirmation.view. Okay, we need a template. Go ahead, paste that in. And then we need our script tags. We need a define component. And again, this is from view. And we just need to wrap this in parentheses. Okay, great. So now in the index page, we need to bring in that component. And we're going to pass in the order. Now the order that we're passing in is coming from our data property order, which we're getting when we send the Axios request. This order equals response.data.order. We're passing it up into the component. So let's bring in that component. Let's just clean this one up a little bit and we need to pass in some props. Well, the only prop that we need to pass in here is order. Let's give this a try. Grab that user again while that's refreshing. Okay, so it looks like we have some warnings over here. Confirmation key order failed to resolve component link. Oh, I need to bring in that link. I think it's Inertia View 3. Yeah. Let's try it again. So now we've got it again, no error, which means extracting the component actually worked. Let's go ahead and start working on that print functionality. We'll go ahead, open this up, and I want to put the button, let's see, under the H2, we'll do a div of the classes of flex, justify between item center and width full. Then I want two divs. We'll put this first one up top, separate it like that, just to make it a bit clearer. And then here we'll add our button. I'm going to use a yellow button for this, and it's going to be as button class equals text small and we'll do at click equals print. And then for the text, we'll just say print. Okay, let's go ahead and import that yellow button. Okay, let's make sure that we just see that. Okay, so there's our button right there. And property print was accessed, but it wasn't defined. That's because we haven't defined it yet, but we have our button and it's got our styling on it. Fantastic. So let's get this working. Now to get this to print, JavaScript has a function already for this. And we've already called it print. And to call that function, all we need to do is window print. So hopefully this works. Let's go and give it a try. Okay, so no more error. Let's go ahead and click print. And so now we have a printing function. Now the first things that we want to get rid of are this hamburger and this print. It shouldn't be here. It looks tacky. So let's get rid of that first. So in order to do that, we need to head to our nav component. And the first one for this button here, that's for the hamburger, we're going to identify this as hamburger. The next thing we need to do is on the confirmation page, our print right here, we're also going to give it an ID. And we're just going to call it print. If we head down to the bottom, we can add some styling. And we're just going to say at media print. And for our button, and our print button, we're going to display none. Let's give that a look. Again, we're getting rid of this print right here and this hamburger. We can also close this. Okay, go ahead, print. So those are gone. The next thing I want to do is I want to add some padding to this confirmation. So we'll do that. And the next thing we'll do is to get rid of this top where it says the date, time, and the name of our page and stuff like that. And at the bottom here where it says localhost 8000 checkout and the page number, we can also get rid of that. So the first thing that I want to do is we need on our confirmation, we need to add an ID to that as well. So we'll do it right before the class. We'll just call it confirmation, keep it simple. So no hashtag confirmation. And we're just going to give it some padding. We'll do 20 pixels, top and bottom, 30 pixels for the left and right side. Give that some space. And to handle that extra top information and bottom information, we need to do at page. We're going to add a size property. It's going to be auto. And the margin will be 0 mm. Let's give that a try, and that should be it. So again, we're getting rid of this. We're getting rid of this down here. And we are giving some padding to this confirmation number. So we'll go ahead and click print. Okay, so that gave us some padding, and we also lost that sort of header and footer that we had here. Fantastic. If you're enjoying the content, please go ahead and click that like button as it really does help out the channel. I'm going to leave links in the description, including the playlist, so that you can catch up on all of the videos in this Laravel e-commerce series. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.